playmakers and finishers were in sync on every level.
Yeah, yeah, what it do, man? Young Dre and this motherfucker playing his clean ass.
Check, how do you think New Orleans played?
2K16 for the foe, you dig? It's chilling and shit, you know what I'm saying? So let's get started. All right, go.
Goes out on the three-point shooters. You gotta prevent the open looks. They weren't fighting through screens. They're just not doing enough on him, especially outside.
And that'll wrap up our halftime show, the third quarter.
Welcome back, everybody. Third quarter just about to get going here in what has been so far a runaway game.
Some fantastic numbers here for the Prodigy. He has 15 points. He's got 9 points from behind the arc.
And that's been an important part of his game today. It's really
number 12.
Taking a look at the Rockets. You've got Jordan.
AJ Legend.
And there's the Prodigy. And it's Harden in at the point guard. Now here's Gordon. Kicks it to Davis. Oh, and that one, no question. Powered it down.
Kevin, he's been a bright spot in what's otherwise been a little bit of a struggle for this team.
Rockets leading by 17.
And really, I thought Anthony Davis a season ago just took the lead by storm. I mean, jaw-dropping numbers. I think you could argue if the Pelicans' record had been a little better, he probably would have won the league MVP.
Paul with the ball, and it's Harden picking him up. Paul goes in, gets to the rim for two, and the D all over. Paul's got seven.
Really aggressive play there, taking it to the rack. Against the big fella.
You know, shit. This is really the only option when you're on the wrong side of the size equation.
Tries again and a misplay.
That's the kind of D that you need when he's got the ball near the hoop. They were all
bang, bang.
No doubt that is within his range.
Well, I would hope so. He's a pro and it was only a one footer. Come on.
Boy.
Pelicans trailed by 19. Timeout called here. The Pelicans decide to talk it over. It's been quite a game for the Prodigy.
He's definitely rolling offensively. You might not be able to stop him, but you've got to find a way to contain him.
And let's get this update now from Doris Burke, who's across the way on the sideline.
Guys, over that last break, I listened in on Alvin Gentry's huddle. He said their plan was run their offense through Anthony Davis. Coach asked him directly to take the reins of their
shit.
Offense.
Story, Doris. And he finishes it off with a one-handed jam.
And just scrapes and claws for that offensive rebound and doesn't take any chances there
with the put. G.A. strong work all around and the rebound and the stuff both. Wow.
Yep, he stayed with it all the way and got his reward at the end.
And just a little bit ragged defensively there, Clark.
Pelicans trail by 20. Holiday dishes to Chandler. Chandler a screen. Davis the pass to Holiday. And that one falls coming off of Davis's feet.
And that's got to happen if they want to have a chance to turn this thing around. I mean, he needs to just take the game over. I mean, it seems like he's been hesitant to pull the trigger.
Another pass put right into the shooter's pocket, right in the shooting pocket, for a terrific assist. They've done a lot of that today.
And it's something we haven't seen much of at the opposite end of the floor.
And so here is New Orleans, following the score by Houston.
Perfect screen there, set him up with a terrific look.
Yeah, I like the fact that the setup was good, the screen was solid, but you also have to look at the fact that the defender didn't do his job as well as he could have.
Yeah, man. Kind of dumb.
He has come through big time. You got to keep getting him touches.
Holiday with it, and it's Harden picking him up. And Holiday kicks to Davis. Nice pass. Right for the rack, perfectly for the win. Davis has got 10 points.
They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
Bang, bang, nigga. That post up, man.
Nothing extravagant, guys, but again, no need on that one.
Here's Gordon. The Rockets making the shot. Outside, Davis. Holiday dishes to Gordon. Bangs on the trifecta. 7 points in the game.
It's just run of the mill for him. Typical day at the office. He's one of the more skilled offensive players out there.
And that one's good. And the Rockets lead by 20.
He is on fire from beyond the arc.
Yeah, it seems like all of his points are coming from deep, Greg.
Holiday, the pass to Chandler. Gordon kicks to Davis. Banked in off the glass.
Hey.
Davis has got 8 points in the quarter.
That's really told the story today, guys. I mean, throughout this game, they've been able to get the ball in tight and then finish.
More active and more physical down low. That's what's really been the difference thus far.
The three quarters of play all in the books, and this one all but over. And we're rolling here again with the fourth quarter. Might not come down to the wire, but you never know. Here's the monster. Bird is out there with Davis. Then there's Tyreek Evans. And there's the monster. And it's all in at the one spot. So that's the group out there for New Orleans. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give them
shit out of here, boy.
Remember, for a long time, flopping was like the number one concern in the NBA. I mean, it still happens a lot, but the rules have curbed quite a bit. Less and less flopping the last few years.
Shooting two. And he makes the first. Some doubted how the flopping fines would have worked. Overall, there have been less egregious flops for the better in the NBA.
Yeah, and there will always be room for embellishment, but I like the fines because it really does minimize the number of extravagant flops. Guys have adjusted and they're not laying down as much as they used to.
And the dunk by O'Neal.
Bang, bang.
Easy guy to stop when he's got his sight on the rim.
Never has been, never will be. He is a determined finisher.
Did he just go chop chop there with that one hand tomahawk slam?
Davis setting the pick for Evans. Inside, Bird. Malone with the block.
The edge on the glass is the difference. It's allowed them to build.
Damn it.
And it's really a reflection of their superior effort level to this point. It seems to me they've gone after this win a little bit more.
Paul goes in, kicks it out to Evans, lets it go from deep, and a great assist by Paul.
Yeah, I think this is a teammate, the most three-pointers against me.
But recognize that there was a better option. That's what we mean by playing for your teammates.
Malone in the high post. And count the basket, he was fouled, and he's going to the line for one more.
Yeah, terrific play right there. Great strength to finish through the contact.
That's exactly how it should be done. Get the bump, concentrate on the shot, and you'll get the bucket too.
And a moment here to take a look at the scoring breakdown for the Rockets.
Fantastic passing. We saw it in the first half, and it's carried over here in the second.
They've really been on fire from beyond the arc tonight, too. I mean, a lot of their points have come from out there.
And, you know, for so long, the NBA has had 12-minute quarters. In last year's preseason, they began experimenting with the 10-minute quarters. Players seem to like it, but it would be a huge change philosophically in terms of how the game is played.
Davis with a screen on Hart. Paul goes in. Beautiful dish, and the layup goes down.
They're doing their best to erase the deficit here with some smart passes and some good shooting. I mean, those two things go hand in hand. You're going to make shots, and the passes have to be on target and on time.
Jordan with it. Picked up by Davis. Here's Malone. And Houston again with the bucket. Here's Paul. Pass to the monster. It's rebounded by Houston. Shaq's got his fifth rebound right now in the game. Deflects the pass. and a wide open look for Jordan, and another three for Houston.
Gotta be demoralized. They desperately needed a stop. Instead, they give up a triple on an open look.
There's the screen. Ball kicks to Bird. Davis sets a screen. Here's the monster, guarded by Jordan.
And that's, it's close, but
what?
He didn't get on balance.
Hell nah.
As quick as players are at this level, in this day and age, I mean, you've got to be perfect in your anticipation to draw the charge.
Tyson Chandler is checking for New Orleans. Gordon comes in for Tyree Devin. Bird's shot is good. There's a minute 40 left in the fourth quarter of this one. Here's the prodigy, outside Jordan, green by Malone, the drive by Jordan, Chandler with the block.
Yeah.
And as we head to the final buzzer here, a crushing blowout, big time dominance, and this will go in the record books as a galley win for the Rockets.
The sheer volume of three-pointers was the deciding factor tonight.
Oh, that was goaltending right there.
Doing everything right, and the points came in bunches. Definitely had the hot heat.
Catching up on the changes for New Orleans. Ryan Anderson, he's checked in for Chandler. The Monster comes in for Bird. Tyreek Evans is checked in for Eric Gordon. And it's Holiday in for Chris Paul. Feeds it to Davis. Free throw line jump shot. The shot is off. O'Neal with the defensive effort. The Rockets have gone an outstanding 4-5 from the field in the fourth quarter so far. Down low. It's
what the fuck? What type of pass was that, bud? That's for no alley-oop, nigga.
Really no idea why you're fouling in a situation like that. You know, maybe there's some bad blood between those two.
Yeah, but that's no excuse for that kind of foul. I mean, that might be an explanation for it, but it certainly doesn't justify it. And even then, it's just not a good play.
Omerash, he's checked in for New Orleans. There's the pass to Malone. Here's Shaq, and it's good. Walk through contact, it's the shot. He'll go to the free throw line.
And they've just done a great job of keeping this crowd out of the game. And they're getting closer to victory. The crowd's getting quiet.
And there's not a whole lot for them to be cheering about anymore. I mean, their guys got it handed to them.
It's 9 seconds separating the shot clock and game. And Holiday kicks to Anderson. And a miss there on the triple. And so it's Houston with it. Now this one is winding down now. Houston can watch the clock run out.
I don't even talk, I let the Visa speak, and I like my Sprite East.
Here's the prodigy. He dishes it to Hart.
I have more juice than
to the right
Cuba.
Side.
Touching, I will your medulla.
And here's Jordan outside. Nails it.
Well, if it wasn't out of reach, it is now, thanks to that last little spurt.
And watch the brakes on now.
We got him on, too.
So we see the Rockets taking the win here. This crowd was stunned by the manner in which their team was dismantled.
You know what? Shocking.
It was a good game, no?
The matchup is you never expect a road team to come in and just cruise to the kind of win they did tonight.
The 2K Sports post-game show.
Check it out. Never knew a friend till I met a foe.
Ernie Johnson again, folks, alongside Kenny the Jet Smith and Shaquille O'Neal. Time now to take a peek at our Jordan player of the game.
Yeah, man, you already know, legend.
My word, that was just huge, and the impact carried them through the entire game.
Oh, Jordan.
There was nothing they could do to slow them down. Man, going to a building on the road and completely control the action like he did, only a few players could do that, Ernie. I'm impressed.
He was dead on from the field tonight, guys. I call his performance economical because there was no wasted opportunities. He took advantage of every good look he got. I mean, everything he put up was going in.
And that brings us to the end of our broadcast for this evening.
My highlight reel, man. Hopefully the tape don't stop. Soon as this shit come on. Young Jordan.